Good morning, everyone. We welcome you to this open day broadcast that we are doing virtually. We appreciate you for joining us, and we believe in the course of the few minutes you are going to spend with us, we'll be able to try to convince you on few information about the school, CPTech University. Firstly, I want to just talk about the reason why we are doing this. Normally, our plan was to hold an open day across 8 countries within West Africa to be able to share some of the ideas of how CPTech came to be, what we are offering, and what we are doing differently. Vis-a-vis also too, what are the impacts that we tend to make in the economy of the sub-Saharan Africa. Firstly, CPTech or CPTEC, as the name means in French, is actually Centre de Perfectionnement or Technique Économique et Commercial, which means Centre for Development in Economic and Commercial Techniques. And the key major thing supports the school basically is actually being set up as a professional academic institution that focuses firstly on economics, commercial and marketing, and also to engineering and technology at this particular end. CPTech was accredited higher institution since 2003. Though as we go on, we'll talk more about the history of the school. And in addition to that as well too, we're looking at one of the key major leverage area of the school as well too. CPTech, as we said earlier, is a fully accredited both in the courses and in the school by the Ministry of Higher Learning in Lomé, Togo, the Federal Republic of Togo. And one of the key major things that we try to do as the objective is to reposition African economies towards the achievement of the sustainable development goals through investment in human capital development and research. What we're saying in the course of this particular open day, we are going to be talking more about the SDG goals, especially the 2050 declaration by the UN that every other country in the world has been leveraging on, looking at how 2030 should be able to look at in terms of sustainable development goals that every nation needs to be, in which we have keyed our core objectives on as well too. Our key major focus as a school is to bring innovation also, among other things, to the various challenges facing Africa. And one of the key major things we are also focusing upon is to look at the sub-Saharan Africa, especially the West Africa, and see how we can actually bring the skills and the innovative responses to majority of the challenges which we are going to be looking at. One of the cutting edge, or what we actually term the key major niche about the school, is the opportunity of giving a migrating ability of a bilingual human capital development, whereby across the region of West Africa, for instance, people can be able to apply their trade, work, carry out businesses effectively because of the ability given by CPTech to every student or every participant in our program. Now, I want us to just briefly look at our story briefly. How do we came to where we are today? Our story commences in 1999. Sometimes when we try to look at the nature of the academics that is being offered, a lot of us came together and look at the future that we need to actually change the way things has been done. Because we have seen that at that particular period, the various institutions within the country were not catching up with the global development as at then, about 20 years ago, 2 decades. And that makes us to be a bit worried that what are the kind of things that we are doing? This really gives us a lot of headache, and over the period, we've been trying the best we could do. And as I said, this is 2020. Majority of the fears we have there are already in. And also to creating so much problem as well too. Our journey moved to 2003 when we started the Davis Business Academy, which is now CPTech Business School, Customs Street, and every other institution. We started by actually trying to bring in a way to bridge academics and professionalism together, because we discovered that majority of the graduates, even as at then, after leaving the school and going to the industry, we are not able to meet the expectation of the various industrial objectives and even aspiration. So we now decide that, okay, why don't we find a way to midwife this? So we started a business school whereby we are able to find a way to bring in the academics and professionalism together. A lot of us people went into a lot of universities, polytechnics in Lagos and other suburb to be able to teach and be able to bring them to full. 2005, we commenced Davis Graduate School of Finance. And what we did basically then was we pick a particular area of great importance, the finance sector, and see, let us see what we can do with the finance sector. In fact, we commenced it by training people that wants to become stockbrokers, financial analysts, and every other related area like accounting. And what we tried to do was not only to be able to just lecture them on the exam, but to teach them the practical of how they can handle the various challenges operationally in the system. We go beyond just the qualification, which has been the problem of Africa over a period of time, and try to instill the expectation of the industry from every graduate, and it yields a lot of fruit. In fact, today, we are always able to boast that over 60% of the stockbrokers, young stockbrokers, 2005 till date in Nigeria, we train them. In 2015, after many years of finding a way to be able to secure academic license, because we discover after moving to 13 countries in Africa that the key major challenges which is affecting the system, the economy, and various other human capital is the paper qualification. Now, it does not matter how many training you give to people. The minute they don't have that qualification or a degree or a diploma, they still find it very hard to be able to secure employment. So we decided that it is very, very important for us to pursue what we said in 2003 by applying for university licenses, which we tried seriously in Nigeria. Then we're able to get one or two inroads in some sort of economy in West Africa, in Benin Republic, in Togo. So we're able to register about 3 universities at that particular point to be able to achieve this. And last year also too, we are able to get accreditation, full accreditation for all our programs and for a university called CPTech. 2019 comes the rebranding and reposition of CPTech University. Now, CPTech University on its own started in 2003, offering degrees, bachelor degrees and master degrees. Fully accredited institution that focuses on national training in the Federal Republic of Togo. So after we reposition the institution, we are able to channel across the 17 countries in West Africa and see how can we leverage our objective, aspiration of making sure that the continent is actually able to go from where it was to where it's supposed to be. And let us now quickly look at our story going further. One of the key major things that underline our story over a period of time is the key major questions that needs to be answered. Because the key major thing people always ask us is that when you say all these things are not doing, why don't you do your own? Naturally, we are supposed to have seek a university license. In fact, the last 20 years, we partner with about 19 schools, both locally and abroad. But one way or the other, we are still not able to get the vision. And what is the vision we are talking about? Is the change curriculum, which will be able to train the people in the way the industry wanted and the way the future is supposed to be positioned. We are going to look at some few questions that actually raise the foundation of CPTech. Now, the first question basically that faced us sometimes ago was the education curriculum in Africa and in the sub-region. One of the key parts is that in Africa till today, we still believe that people will need to leave the university, polytechnics, or colleges before they start entrepreneurship. And that is why, despite every investment, everything done by various institutions is not yielding any effort. All over the world, like we learned in Asia from 2009 till date, is that they need to start entrepreneurship while they are in school, not when they leave school. Because a lot of factors actually, this is one of the major questions that we try to do with the build of institution in Africa to change the curriculum to answer this, and which is what CPTech is embodying in part of its program, whereby from the day one that you register for either a degree, a PhD, or a master's program, you are already being trained to be an entrepreneur, which means after your first year, you're already going through an experiential learning that will make you to have your own businesses, to focus on what you want to be. So you don't actually leave a school with economics and start doing makeup artists going forward, which I say is not really a bad thing. But now the next question is, how do we move our system of education to a developmental and transformative? Today, one of the key major things that actually create problem for people, like we see in this country today, is that there are so many graduates in the system. Despite that, a lot of companies are still having problem in recruiting some. A lot of the graduates are not transforming the what they've learned into the developmental and transformation. Today, most of the countries, especially in West Africa, that was actually being termed among the 30 of the poorest nations, today we're not able to transform the learning they've learned, especially in the last 30 years, to how to develop the continent. That is a major thing that gives us worry at this particular extent. Is it that this economy system is not actually training you these people for it, or the people itself are not doing so? After our extensive research, we discovered that with a curriculum in which we are actually embodying on, we should be able effectively to be able to see how we can focus on the key major areas. We're going to talk about them, about pillar, as we keep on going, how CPTech will evolve itself, not only into academics, professionalism alone, but as a transformative and developmental agent as well, too. Then also, too, one of the key major questions that we asked 2 decades ago and is now being thrown in our face today is the issue is, where is the region? When I say region for now, I'm talking about West Africa. This is our major focus of catchment area for the first 10 years of our activity. Where is the region going to be in 2020? We talked about 2010 earlier. We've passed it. We are now in 2020, which means our initial plan that everything that we expected to have done, it's not been done. Then UN with their SDG is talking about 2030. Even the countries like Nigeria, Togo are bringing in vision to talk about 2030, 2050. These are part of the question that beg for answer and which we are talking about. Then the key major part also too is, how will we be able to complete a global productive skill human capital index and skill migration? Because we believe one of the key challenges facing the system, especially the region today, is we don't have productive skills. Despite people have so many qualifications in the system, this is what CPTech has built together as a module and curriculum to look at, not only to train people with the skill alone, but productive skills that can actually make them to actually perform better, improve the human capital indexes, and more than any other thing, which we have not been doing, it to be able to have skill migration, to be able to export skills all across the world. This is the key major thing that CPTech has built in. And also to looking at, how do we make the region West Africa within the next 10, 20, 30 years nation, developmental nation in the world, in terms of the human capital that is available, so that we don't need to actually have to bring everything outside the country, including people, to actually carry out tasks for us, develop every infrastructure and wonderful area we have in the system. All these are the key things that actually we put together that CPTech is about to address. We'll talk about a lot of them and how we want to achieve it as we keep on going. Now, our some facts that actually throws us on the face. which we've been trying to work on. And as at this particular year, we are going to share the few of them which we have built together as a model, and also to a concept which we are following. As of today, we are told that the 54 countries in Africa is having about 1.36 billion population. And West Africa alone, with 17 countries, is having about 405 to 421 million population. Now, I want to just be able to look at that, and it's still growing. I mean, some analysts recently, in the last couple of months, believe that the next, by 2050, African population, especially from the sub-Saharan Africa, is going to double, and in 2000, it will triple. I believe this number, I mean, I was thinking that a lot of our decision maker will have been a bit worried in Africa. We are told that a lot of things is actually happening in terms of what is being earned. Despite having so many population graduates, we still discover that the nation, especially the sub-region, has so many resources in terms of mineral and human. And despite that, the country is still heavily a net importer of everything, even including water. Another major key that we look at also too is that after careful research of over 3 decades being revealed, that the sub-region of West Africa is less than 3% developed in infrastructure, in trade and industry. All these things, these are the things that give us the key major blow, and we keep asking, is there no solution in sight? Despite and CPTED, as we decide on the Zoom, is going to take up the change and the challenge, among other things. CPTED as an institution is going to develop a knowledge-based economy, because if the economy is well knowledgeable, well communicated, we'll be able to see ahead of most of the problems we are, as we have seen 20 years ago. And the next 10, 20, 30 years as well, too, we will have been able to project it, build a knowledge base around it, and work towards it. In addition to that, we believe what the system needed now is to be able to develop strategic leaders with productive skills that can actually drive the economy of the sub-region. We believe also, too, among other things, what we have been eradicating for the last 2 decades is it's time to bring academic, professional, and industry. This expectation needs to actually be made. There should be a convergence in which CPTech is talking about. So when somebody leaves school, he does not have to go through another retraining for another 5 years before he can cope in the particular job he's doing. Before anybody can even leave school, he will have been able to run an entrepreneurship, which means that our vision is that 95% of all our students or graduates, computer students, will be able to run an entrepreneurship of their own that will support the economy in which they actually live. I'm going to move the last to the last one. And the major thing we are looking at as CPTech is that we should be able to train people that can actually be exported all over the world today too. There are so many advertisements for skilled people. And that is why we are looking at a bilingual learning that with a Francophone and Anglophone that dominated West Africa. For if you have the build skills together in one, we can be able to go all around, get mobility easily, and be able to trade all these things without no any problem. Now, so who are we and CPTech really, in addition to what we have talked about? Today, we just want to just look at the institution. Like I said earlier, the school is fully accredited, higher learning school. And as we always try to talk to people, you can check our website for our capital status. You can do your due diligence of your own. Our numbers are there, and also too, our years are there. These are just a few things that you can always find on our website in terms of our vision, our mission, even also to our philosophy, what we stand for.